In this session, let us see how to approach IELTS writing both academic and general module. Let us start with the graph description. As you know, the main types of graphs usually asked in IELTS are bar graph, line graph, pie chart, table, procedure and map. When you get a graph, read and understand it well. Your graph should have three parts: introduction, body and conclusion. In the introduction, you have to add the type of graph, the title of graph, data and scale. And in the body, explain the data as shown in the graph using similar words. Try to avoid using the same word again and again. And don't add any of your ideas. Only what you see there in the graph, you have to explain here. In the conclusion, you can explain the overall trend shown in the graph. Let us see an example of an introduction. Just go through this line graph. The line graph compares the rate of smoking in men and women in developed countries between the years 1960 and 2000. It can be clearly seen that the rate of smoking for both men and women is currently declining, that fewer women have smoked throughout the period. So this is a typical example of introduction. Let us see the parts of introduction. Type of graph, the line graph. The graph starts with the line graph, compares the title, the rate of smoking in men and women, data of the graph. Rate of smoking is currently declining and that fewer women have smoked throughout the period. And the scale between the years 1960 and 2000. In the scale, you can add per 1000 people also. So these are the parts that should be included in the introduction. And in the body, you have to explain what you see in the graph. In 1960, 600 men in every 1000 were smoking. This number decreased gradually to 500 by 1974 and continued to decrease, but more steeply to 250 in 2000. That way, in contrast, the rate of smoking in women in 1960 was very low, at only 80 in every 1000. By 1968, this increased to 170. So this way it will go. What you see there, you have to explain. If the data is more, you take the highest, lowest, middle and so on. No need to include everything. And in conclusion, you can conclude the graph by, in conclusion, we can see that the rate of smoking in men dropped throughout the whole period, but was always at a higher level than the female figures. The rate of smoking in women increased until 1977, but then decreased for the rest of the period. So this much only you need to explain the graph. So graph, you can score full if you write without mistakes. And the word limit for graph is 150 words. Be careful with 150 words. You should not be less than 150. You can exceed the word limit, no problem, but it should not be less than 150. How the words are counted? First take two full lines and count the words written there. Take the average, then multiply the lines and see how many words you have written. Now let us see how to write an essay. There are different methods to write an essay, but there should be 250 words and three parts minimum: introduction, body and conclusion. Body, you can make two or three paragraphs also, no problem. Introduction. There are different methods in writing introduction. It is a way of introducing the topic. So easiest method is a general entry to the topic. You can start with a story or you can start with a quotation. It depends on your knowledge. But the easiest way is a general entry to the topic. Then mention two or three points to be explained in the body. Then conclude the introduction part. That is easiest way of presenting introduction. and in the body start with the topic sentence based on the points given in the introduction. Start the body with the topic sentence. Topic sentence tells what you are going to write in this paragraph. Then explain with the sub-points and sub-sub-points. For example, if it is pollution, in the introduction you can tell there are different types of pollution and most important ones are man-made and nature-made, and even this man-made pollution is the most serious one. So introduction over. And in the body, how man is polluting the air. You can start, man is the main polluter of the air as the topic sentence. Then one who read this sentence will understand this topic is about, this paragraph is about how men pollute the air. So for that one you have to find out sub points, factories, vehicles, from houses, cooking. That way how many sub points you can find out, explain with the sub points. That way, and the next paragraph you can tell how nature is polluting nature. As a topic sentence, though less, nature also pollute nature. Then find out sub points and sub sub points for the paragraph. Dust, wind, volcanoes, forest fire, all this one you have to explain with the sub points. And you have to add one example in the essay. That is a must. One example, either a real example or fabricated also, but it should have a real reality touch. Then in conclusion, your suggestions, what people should do, what government should do, or even your solutions also, you can add in the conclusion. This is the easiest way of writing an essay. Now let us see how to write a letter. Letter writing is in the general module. So in letter also there should be three parts: introduction, body and conclusion. The introduction part you have to write, why do you write this letter? I am writing this to tell these things. So introduction, a short introduction is enough. And in the body, explain the matter in details. The question, there will be three points. You have to explain that three points in detail. That is what you have to do in the body. And conclusion, you have to tell what do you expect. So your expectation is the conclusion. So that much only about IELTS writing. So graph, essay and letter. Letter for general module. And letter also 150 words. It should not be one less than 150. Marks will be deducted. For your doubt clearance, you can use my email ID. Thank you for listening.